Hey everybody, what's up? Hernan Vazquez here. On this video, I'm going to show you how to use the new Facebook pixel to create custom audiences and how to target them via retargeting. So if that's something that you want to do, stay with me because I'm going to show you how. Let's do this. Hey guys, what's up? Hernan Vazquez here. Welcome to another video. This is a question that has been posted on the Real Internet Marketing group, the group that I kind of manage. I wouldn't say I own, because Facebook owns it, you know, and I hopefully won't get charged like a landlord fee or something like that. But anyways, that's the group I manage, and you're welcome to join. I'm gonna leave a link over here so that you can join that Facebook group, and you can drop questions. I try to drop a ton of value over there, and it's completely free, and I will thrill that you join, because there's a bunch of other entrepreneurs asking questions, fighting each other, throwing food, etc. It's a ton of fun. Now, the truth is that I got a question the other day. Was, you know, Facebook has changed the pixel. A couple of months ago, you would have different pixels for different audiences, all right? So let's say that you have three websites. You will have one pixel per website, and then you can do some retargeting campaigns to those websites or to those audiences based on the pixel. Now, Facebook changed the mechanics. Now it's one pixel for all of your ads account. Now the question would be, how do you divide the different audiences if you're using the same pixel or the same ads account for many websites? Or on the same website, you have different processes, like you have free subscribers, you have people that actually reach the end of your shopping cart, meaning a sale, you know, people that actually download this PDF and not this one. How do you divide those, and how do you make tailored campaigns for each of those with one pixel? And that's the beauty of Facebook, and that's exactly what I want to show you guys, how to set up the Facebook pixel, the retargeting pixel, and then how to use that pixel to make a ton of retargeting campaigns at different audiences using just one pixel. So let's hop into the computer, and I'm going to show you how to set this up, and we'll see how it goes. Okay guys, so let's hop into that. All right guys, so welcome to one of my Facebook accounts. Okay, so once you have your ads account, in order to set up different audiences for the same pixel, first off, you need to install the pixel in all of the pages that you want to retarget people after, okay? So let's say that you want to install the pixel in your website so that you can later serve a retargeting campaign. So what you want to do is to go into the Ads Manager. This, of course, could potentially change when you're watching this video, but follow me here. So you will go into the Ads Manager, and here, what you want to do is to go to All Tools. I have it already here because I use it a lot, but here on the All Tools, you will go to Pixels, okay? So here in Pixels, what you wanna do is to, here on Actions, you want to view the pixel code. And here's the pixel code that you're gonna be using, as you know already, to all into all of your website. Now, you want to install this between the heads, okay, the head tags of your website. If you're not clear about this, you may want to talk to the guy that designed your website, or if you're using WordPress, for example, you can install a plugin that's called headers and footers. I'm going to leave a link below. It's a free plugin, and you can install it, and it will allow you to put these kind of scripts and pixels and whatnot on the head of your website. So let's copy this for a second. So we're going to copy this, I'm gonna paste it. Okay, so we have, here's the pixel that we're gonna be using. Now, you want to install these on all of your pages of your website. So again, you wanna copy this on the head of your entire website. So once you're done with that, and let's say that you have installed this pixel on many websites, okay? Because again, this is one ads account, and again, this is one pixel for all of your websites. So as you can see here, I have it on many websites. The same pixel, I have it on many websites. I have it on a blog, I have it on hernanvazquez.com, I have it on a couple of websites of myself, okay? So, as you can see, Facebook is automatically determining where the traffic is coming from. So, if I wanted to create
a custom audience for this blog, I would do it. If I wanted to create a custom audience for this blog, I can do it, and also this, okay? So once you install this pixel on different websites and you leave it like a couple of days, okay, because the pixel needs to be activated, then you come here to pixels and you will see, if you go to the domain columns, you will see what are the domains that are actually triggering the pixel. So once you have this, you can create an audience based on these URLs. So for example, let's say that I want to target people that visit hernanvazquez.com. So what I would do is to use website traffic, anyone who visit your website, and then what I want to do is to use hernanvazquez.com. So what this is going to do is to create a custom audience that, you know, anyone that visits my websites, doesn't matter which kind of, which part of the website, I just want to retarget them all. So then I would use this audience and put visitors to hernanvazquez.com. All right. So this way, what you're doing is to tell Facebook that you want to target only the people that trigger the pixel from this domain and nothing else. All right. So then you will create the audience, and then you can use this audience on your ads. So that makes sure you're making sure that you're using, or you're retargeting rather, you're serving those ads to the people that visit this blog. I could do it conversely, I could do it with any of these URLs right here. Now, we can go even deeper than that. Let's say that you have a shopping cart in your website, and then the last page of the shopping cart, when they actually purchase, is, let's say that it's hernanvazquez.com/thank you. So what I want to do is to potentially serve ads to people that have purchased before, okay? So how do you do that? Well, basically, instead of using anyone who visits your website, you would do people who visit specific pages, okay? So people who visit specific pages, here I will do with URL contains, and here I would put something like hernanvazquez.com/thank you. Okay? This would be this here. This would be the thank you page for a purchase. So instead of visitors, this will be purchasers. Okay? Purchasers on hernanvazquez.com. And you can create this audience and you can serve ads to this audience. Now, if you want to go even deeper, what you can do is to go with people visiting specific web pages, but not others. This is useful when you have, for example, a lead magnet, and then you have an offer. So, but you wanna serve ads to people that downloaded your lead magnet, but didn't visit the thank you page. That means that people, you know, they are interested in your stuff, but they haven't purchased. So URL contains, hernanvazquez.com/download, for example, and exclude people who visit any web page that meets the following rules. That means hernanvazquez.com/thank you. Okay, so the download /download would be the actual download page for my lead magnet, and the thank you would be the actual, you know, thank you when they purchase. So then I could put something like free downloads on hernanvazquez.com. And as you can see, these are all being fired from the same pixel, okay? So you have all of these options, and then you have custom combinations like, you know, conditions, if you wanna go really, really ninja, like if you wanna create like a retargeting path, etc. You can go, for example, for devices, you know, depending on where they are visiting, like Android phone, desktop, iPhone. You want to go for URLs, for example, people that visit one URL and not the others. Let's say that here I have some recipes, so I would be, you know, better off serving these people recipes PDFs, for example, okay? And then salad, so I would send people, you know, a salad PDF or something like that, okay? Now, the other thing that you could do is to create conversions. And this is like a really advanced thing. So what you want to do is Facebook will give you a ton of different conversions. Okay, so track conversions with standard events. So as you can see, these are the events names. So view content, when somebody sees, you know, sees a product page or a landing page or an article. So this is going to be a view content. Then add to cart, you know, when somebody adds to cart and then you show him the cart. Initiate checkout. You know, these are all little steps that you can use on your pixel. I'm going to show you how to edit your pixel. Purchase. You know, when somebody purchases, at the end of the shopping cart, okay, you can do purchase, you can do lead. For example, I would add this lead on the after they have download, for example, or after they have register or complete registration, for example. So as you can see on the pixel here, I have this right here, okay, which is FBQ track page view. So this is going to track a page view. So this, I will put it, this code, I will put it on all of the pages of my website. However, I could also track leads. So let's say that I want to use this pixel code. And all I need to do here is to change this. So instead of FBQ, you know, track page view, I would add FBQ track lead. So I'm going to paste it like that. And this code, I will use it on the conversion page for a lead, okay? When somebody, you know, when somebody downloads a lead magnet. Now, another is, let's say that I want to add another pixel to somebody that purchased. So here I would use purchase. And here, which is cool, I could add values too. And they will show, these values will show on your ads manager. So here, let's say that the purchase, the value is 97, currency USD, of course. So every time this pixel is initiated or fired, this is going to count as a purchase. And these purchases are actually showing on your Facebook ad. So if you're tracking conversions on your Facebook ad, it will tell you the ROI. This is kind of a more advanced feature. Sometimes all you need to set this up is to actually set up the URLs, and that's pretty much it. But if you want to go really ninja and you want to go really deep, you can use the custom conversions. Okay, you can also create your own conversions, like track custom conversions, like if the, you know, if people URL contains, I don't know, /thank you, this will count as a purchase. But this is kind of the more advanced side of things. All right, guys, so here, this is how you track your different domains, your different pages, your different steps in your shopping cart, in your sales funnel with the same pixel. As you can see, I only made a couple of changes to the pixel, or even you can create an audience based on what people visit. All right, guys. So hopefully this is helpful. If you have any questions whatsoever, drop them on the comment. I will be more than happy to answer them. And share this with somebody that needs to see it, okay? Click on the subscribe button if you love it, and I'll see you guys on the next video.